Hello, everyone. My name's Duran Bunzalini. Born Mundunderan. That's the Pelican and the Eagle tribe, Illinois. Saying all. And that's what we have. In the last 231 years of this illegal occupation, we have witnessed this. We have a perspective of what happened in this country. It's not just all the white man's perspective. That's the way it's been for a long time in this country. Well, today, all that ends. It's game over. End of the day. Checkmate. This is our land. Crimes against humanity. Illegal occupation. It needs to be resolved, folks. It's one of the reasons why our land is in such trouble today. There's no care for it. The white man has been raping, pillaging, plundering this sacred land for as long as they've been here. Australia's the only Commonwealth country that hasn't got a treaty. Now, a treaty is a peacemaking instrument of international law. The only Commonwealth country that hasn't got one is this continent. It's not just some small country.
Shame!
It's shameful. It's a disgrace, this country. And I just want to say thank you to you people who've taken the time, your Saturday morning, to come here and march with our people. Now the tide's turning. The tide is turning. And we need to act quickly. Our people have just cause here. We have a precedent law that outdates this childish crap by hundreds of thousands of years. When is this country going to get serious about it? It's built on lies, deceit, fraud, propaganda, and race hatred indoctrination. How can we be proud of that? What are we leaving for our children here? I worry about the future, because I know there's a parallel between genocide and ecocide. And it's taken the ecocide to kick in before people are going to start doing something about it. They didn't care about our genocide or our customary law that looked after this country for millennia, since the beginning of time, as we say. And when's this going to end? It's an undeclared war, a secret invasion. They came here with the intent to destroy the original nations. Very clear, folks. Do we need to go to the International Criminal Court and drag their sorry asses through that to get some justice? Or can we talk together and come up with a solution together? We're peacemakers. It might look like we are, but we are that. We understand what you need to, the laws you need to coexist. We know what it is. We had 600 independent black nations on this continent that lived in harmony with each other. You've all got something to learn from us. You need to come back through our customs. Don't bring your backward law here and impose it on us. We don't need it. We don't need your welfare. All we need is people to recognise our most basic and fundamental human rights. That hasn't been done. There's no convention for genocide prevention in this country. They suspend the Race Discrimination Act when they deal with our issues. These are international laws. Now you're bringing your children up, non-Aboriginal people, on this issue. or on this situation? Do you want that to be the reality down the track?
No!
I see Australia like the apartheid of the South Pacific. It controls all this region. This one here. Lawless, racist in the extreme, and guilty of everything defined as genocide in terms of the United Nations Convention. There's no doubt about it. It's a Nazi wet dream. You make Nazis look like amateurs. When you look at this history, folks, and that's what's going to judge it at the end of the day, and your children, you're going to see what we're saying is true. And when that truth becomes a part of this country's character, because it's built on lies, when that becomes a part of the society, our truth, we can all walk together. We can all trust each other. And we've got a great opportunity, because the Aboriginal people have left the window open for humanity to step back through there. We didn't see our sovereignty. We've got unceded sovereignty. All that needs to happen is the people support the law of the land here and remove this criminal element you call a government. They don't care about your own people. So, I think it's the end of the day, all's been said and done. We're still talking about peace. At the embassy, we've been there for 47 years. They haven't taken the time to walk 200 metres and meet with us. How simple is that? You know, that game's over. Because we're all becoming aware. Now, we've all got our iPhones now. There's no excuse. Google it. Let's get on the same plane here, or train. And that's what's going to shape-shift this country, right? It's never had a revolution, but it's always been revolting. Let's change that. Let's remove this system. Bloodless coup, of course. Right? We can do that. We hold the morality, the ethics, the law. It's time to give us a break, folks. Get your jacknecks off, your jack boots off our necks. We've had no peace in 200 years. And we had a pristine environment with a very healthy population here. And since colonialism has occurred, it's been a downhill slope. A 90 degree drop in terms of our health, welfare. Nothing they do is good for us. None of the laws that they make for us have jurisdiction or authority behind it. You know, when you go to their courts, ask the question about the jurisdiction. Whose land is this? Whose law applies? They can't deal with it. I want to acknowledge the original people of this land. Their ancestors and the people of the resistance for the last 230 years and all of our mobs all around this country, all different stages of being colonised. We still have our people living on the land in some of these places in this country, but they're under constant threat from the mining companies who run this country, multinational mining conglomerations. Another name for the United Nations. That's where they come from. In 1949, Australia was supposed to ratify and legislate against the crime of genocide. In 2019, it still hasn't been done. We don't need to ask any more questions. Time for talking is done. 2019, for me, is the year of revelation, where the truth comes out. And we're going to line in for 2020. And we're going to have a whole 12 6 months of programming at the embassy to line that in. This is the end of the day, folks. And I really want to say thank you to all my ancestors who died and spilt their blood on this land, defending it from foreign invasion. It wasn't the Anzacs. It was our blood. Not one monument. Keep that in mind on Anzac Day, folks. Because it's our day too. All right, lest we forget.